Today we're going to be performing pieces that demonstrate how Baroque composers use rhythm and pulse to express a wide range of emotions. Usually you think of harmony and melody as being expressive, but turns out you can be expressive with rhythm too. So the first piece you just heard from a violin partita, it's like the regularity is comforting, can be soothing, and it might allude to a heartbeat, a calm heartbeat. But our next piece has regularity, but it begins, "Time flies and destroys life." Wow. Here the regular beat alludes to the inevitability of death, of the end of time. So we might wish to stop this implacable clock, but we probably hope that the regular heartbeat will keep on ticking. So some regularity we want. And the next couple pieces we're going to play, oh no, let's just play this one first. Now we are going to play two galliards. Galliard is a dance from the Renaissance, and in galliards the meter changes throughout the piece, and it produces lively dance rhythms. They're fun to dance to. The first one is a galliard that has words, "His Golden Locks." It was written for the retirement of a knight who was in the court of Queen Elizabeth, and the poet writes, "Youth waneth by increasing." And then the next one, Byrd is also a Renaissance composer. His Galliard was originally a harpsichord piece, where in addition to the meters changing throughout the piece, he often uses 2 meters simultaneously because the keyboard player has more fingers than sense. But anyway, you could sort of imagine that the dancer's feet are moving with one of the meters while their hands or their arms are moving in a different meter. And after that, we will play Addio Roma, which is from Monteverdi's opera Poppea. Queen Ottavia has been exiled and is being marched to a boat that will take her away from her homeland. Monteverdi uses a halting rhythm to paint her anguish as she struggles to speak her farewell. She stutters through words such as addio. It's not addio, it's addio, amici, and then dagli amati, using the rhythm to heighten her anguish.
Swiftness never ceasing. His youth against time.
Our next piece is not really sung, well, it's sung by the Virgin Mary, but that's, Lori's gonna take her place. Virgin Mary is singing to her baby over a rocking, repeated bass line, which could be reassuring. That swinging motion, that is that steady pulse, it's nice for going to sleep too. But in this case, the lulling motion of the rocking gives a false sense of security because Mary foresees the pain in her son's future. And she comes back to the refrain, now's the time to sleep. Sleep all you can.
Deve il mio del cor mio fa, fa la mia.
How time affects beauty, and there's a short passage in there you might hear chromatic drooping lines, and it refers to what happens to a woman's body parts with age. It's also on a dance rhythm, and then we're going to end with a battle piece which William Byrd wrote for harpsichord, and he saw a series of pictures depicting battle scenes, and he wrote a piece to go along with each using rhythm in a powerful martial way.
Thank you.
today, you will know the sound of a C, because he uses the C chord all the way through this piece. If you can play that chord, you could play along with us.
The battle, the soldier summons. Thank you.
Our thanks to Belladonna and guest artist Laura Himes for this thrilling concert and for reminding us of the centrality of pulse, as essential to music as it is to life itself, and your cardiologist can confirm that. Happy 30th anniversary, Belladonna. Many more. And our thanks, as always, to Rebecca Pachevsky for the use of her beautiful harpsichord on our series. My name is John Teese, and I'm executive director of Gotham Early Music Scene. Midtown Concerts are generously supported by the Howard Gilman Foundation, the New York City Department of Cultural Affairs, the New York State Council on the Arts, and you, our audience. Thank you. For our online viewers, please visit gemsny.org and show your support for this series by making a donation. Join us next week for Suspiros y Cantos, music from 17th century Spain, with Krista Patton and Camila Parias. That's next Thursday here at St. Malachy's Church, the Actors' Chapel, on West 49th between Broadway and 8th Avenue in beautiful Manhattan. Thank you.